Do you want to see something really cool that I made?
Yeah.
It's a top launcher.
Oh, cool. Well, that was so much fun, especially because I won, which is super surprising because you designed this.
That's true, but winning's not everything, Alex.
Oh, okay. Could you tell me about the inspiration behind this?
Yeah, so tops are like one of the oldest toys we know about. They're thousands of years old.
And I think, wow.
Yeah, they're very simple, but I think they're underrated.
Yeah.
I think they're fun to play with, they're fun to watch, and as you saw, you can play with a lot of people too, so it's really cool.
Yeah, and I love that this set, it seems like you could build like any type of top. Could you tell me about what it was like playing with this with kids?
Kids actually really love it because I think they're so customizable,
mm-hmm.
so you can take all these things apart and build them different ways.
Yeah.
And they also liked the fact that you can launch the tops, you know, like normally, like this. Or you can flip it upside down.
Oh, cool.
So we have some that have springs on the bottom.
The springs are awesome. Yeah. I've actually never seen that before.
I saw this top, I think it was in Germany, and it had a little spring on it. And I thought that was so cool. And so we added a spring to the tops, and now they can bounce. They also dance, but you can't quite put it in the launcher because the spring is too tall.
Mm-hmm.
And if the spring's too short, it just doesn't bounce as much. It's not as fun. So to solve that and to kind of have another way of using the launcher,
mm-hmm.
you can flip it upside down. And this little foam piece comes off. And now the spring has plenty of room, so when you pull it, it can drop down and bounce around.
Very cool. This was so fun to learn about. I would really like to build my own set. Would you help me put it together?
Of course.
Oh, wow, it spins. First, grab your launcher base and place it on a flat surface. Then, place your green bolts in all of these little holes. Now, add the wooden launcher piece over the bolts. You might have to wiggle the bolts a little bit to get them all lined up. Now, I'll add this clear launcher piece over all the green bolts. Then I'll grab this small wooden rectangle and it fits in this groove in between these two green bolts, just like that. Now I take one of these wooden curved pieces and these fit on these green bolts off to the side. And do the same thing with the other one on the other side. Now we're at our first stop and check, so we need to make sure that these arrows are pointing inwards towards each other. Not out, not the other way. They're pointing towards each other like this. Now I'll add my other clear launcher piece and add it on top. Just make sure every bolt goes through every hole. Now I'll grab the last wooden piece and place it on top. There we go, it's like a sandwich. Right now, all of these green bolts are laying flat on the table, but I actually want to push them up. So if I tilt this up, I can push. Now all of the bolt heads are all the way up against the wood right above it. Now I'm gonna add the handle to the launcher. It fits into these two center bolts. So make sure that the handle is leaning back towards the straight edge, not towards these curved edges. Now I'm gonna screw my handle in place and use this green nut and tighten it onto this bolt that's poking out. You might need to press down a little bit, and it's easier if you hold the handle in place while you do this. Now the one on the back. Feels nice and sturdy. Now let's screw the rest of the nuts onto these bolts. Now we're gonna start putting together the key for our launcher. So make sure that the KiwiCo logo is facing up. Take this little blue rubber piece and slide it on. Make sure that the holes here line up. Now I'm going to screw the launcher handle in place. So I'll take these two light blue bolts, poke them through, and then just try and hold everything in place while I flip it over and screw the nuts on the other side. Oh, now I have my key. Now I'm gonna grab this crayon and rub it all over the top and inside of this groove. Paul, what is this for?
It's because there's a lot of friction on these wooden parts. So when you add wax to anything, it's kind of like a lubricant. It helps it glide. So you'll be able to pull the launch key out a lot faster.
That's so cool that you can use just a crayon to do that. So I want to scribble all over the top and even inside of the groove. And then I'll flip it over, do the same thing on this side. I guess I could even like secretly write my name. Ooh, cool. Now I have both pieces of my launcher built and it's time to put them together. The key fits into the handle right here on the smooth edge in the back. If you're noticing that it's hard to fit your key into this slot, these bolts might be a little bit over tightened. Try loosening them with a few turns. You can see that that gives it a little bit more space here. And now I can slide the key in like this. Perfect. Your launcher has two spots, here and here, so that you can launch two tops at once. Now comes the fun part. We get to design our tops. Your crate comes with the parts to build two different types of basic tops. The first top we're going to build is called a steady spinner. A steady spinner uses one of our steady stems, and the key to having a top that spins for a long time and spins evenly is having a lot of weight towards the bottom of the top. So I think my best bet is going to start with this big wooden disc, nice and heavy, right at the bottom. And then I might as well decorate it a little bit, so I'll add some of these fun, colorful tiles. And then I'll add this clear disc on top and an O-ring to keep everything in place. And maybe I'll build one more steady spinner. You can also build a steady spinner by using these plastic rings. So I'll start with the steady stem, just like before. And there's a bunch of these really cool, colorful rings, and they stack together. I think I'm gonna use all of them in one just to give it a nice amount of weight at the bottom. And then I'll add this purple clip, there we go, and an O-ring. The coolest part is I really could have done this in any order. I could have put the blue on the bottom, I could have put the purple clip in the middle, I could have done anything, and it would still be a cool spinning top. Now that I have my two steady spinners built, it's time to launch them. So there's two spots on the launcher for your tops, and you just have to make sure that this gear on the bottom lines up with these gear teeth on your key that you're going to pull. So as you're putting it in, just place it, and you might just need to wiggle it in place, but as long as the key is rotating with it, you know that it's in the right spot. I'll add my other top. Ooh, and now for the fun part, I get to launch them. Okay, so I just have to press down firmly and then pull this key back as fast as I can. All right, 3, 2, 1. Nice. Oh, wow, and this one has color mixing on it. That's so cool. The red and the blue are turning purple. The other type of top we can build is called a hoppy top. And it's called that because it has a spring on the bottom of the stem. So any top you build with one of these spring stems is a hoppy top. I think I'm gonna use these cool, colorful discs again. This time, maybe I'll kind of go in reverse. I'll put this light blue one on the bottom, this yellow one on top of it, and then the red one on the very top. And then I'll just grab another O-ring to keep everything in place. Now that I've built my hoppy top, it's time to take it for a spin. To launch your hoppy top, we do it a little bit differently than we did the last one. So before, you still add your key, just like with the first one, but the hoppy top doesn't actually fit on this side because the spring is so tall, the table will get in the way. So instead, we can use the handle to flip this whole thing upside down. You can remove the foam. You won't need it for this. And now the top fits perfectly over here. This works great for the hoppy tops, but it also works for any of the other tops you build. All right, let's try it out. 3, 2, 1.
Wow, very cool.
Look, I did it!
Nice work, Alex.
This is so fun.
Yeah, this is a very steady top. This is a nice, heavy, steady top.
Okay.
So it's really smooth when it spins.
Yeah, what is this one called, the hoppy top?
This is the hoppy part, and then this is like a tower.
Okay,
and it's kind of like a tornado, so it twists.
Very cool.
Yeah, but that one's kind of wild. And then this one you made, you can launch it this way or upside down.
Oh, cool. Can you show me how to launch it upside down?
Yeah, so there's these little gears that slide on.
Yeah.
And so that's so you can put it upside down in the launcher. And it's kind of like with the spring, you have this upside down.
Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh, wow. You can really corral it. Cool. That's awesome. Yeah, I feel like you could make like an infinite amount of
tops. I don't know the math, but it's a lot.
Yeah.
It's a lot of possibilities.
Do you have any tips for people building this at home?
So probably the most likely reason your top isn't spinning well is you're not pulling the launch key fast enough. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so like, watch. If this is kind of fast, it spins, but it won't spin that long.
Yeah.
So what you want to do is make sure that it's not too close to your body.
Mm-hmm.
So you can put it on the table or you can hold it in the air. Doesn't really matter. But you want to like just yank it like really hard. And now it's going to spin for a minute.
Okay, cool. So yeah, I can see it looks more stable.
It probably looks the same, but like really, you want to pull so fast.
Okay.
That's probably the easiest solution to your top not spinning very well.
Okay, cool.
The other thing you might have trouble with is if you feel like the launch key is sticking inside the launcher, these screws might be too tight. So if you just loosen these nuts just a little bit, like maybe just a tiny little turn, that'll make it a lot easier to pull back and forth on the launch key.
Thanks for following along with us today. To see more cool builds like this one, subscribe to our channel. See you next time. Bye. Oh, wow. Cool.
Would you help me put one together?
Of course.
Okay, we just need a box. Oh, okay. Perfect.
I'm going to stand in my chair.
Paul.
Mm-hmm.